Hey everyone, Gabriel Nassif for Channel Fireball and Ultimate Guard, and today I'm going to be playing Modern. I'm going to be playing a brew, see if you can meme and win in Modern. I was on vacation for a week and I started scribbling decklists at some point, and that was one of the decklists I scribbled, so I'm going to give it a shot. You know, once in a while I like to just go back, play mono blue or mono black deck, kind of a little underpowered, maybe a lot underpowered, but it could be fun. We'll see. Maybe blue red Murktide is good enough that even if you cut the good red cards, you still have a decent deck. I initially had a few more one offs like Narset, Vendilion Click. I had a Jace in the main deck. And I decided to streamline the deck and play 4 Murktide as well as 4 Thoughtscour, kind of max out on the good cards, I guess. And yeah, we'll see what happens. Obviously 4 Ledger Shredder as well, a couple Snapcaster Mage. And I'm hoping the cheap cards help me keep up, despite the fact I don't have too much removal. And I'm hoping that Shredder lets me cycle the situational cards like Spell Pierce, Spell Snare, Gutshot, etc. Hoping, you know, between Shredder and Murktide, I close the door fast enough with big Murktides, maybe some crazy draws, maybe some turn two Murktide Regents. We'll see. And yeah, kind of the usual card you would expect, I guess, once you card all the red cards from Murktide. I made up for no removal spell by playing a couple Gutshots as well as a Dismember. And still playing some fetch lands, which is kind of annoying, I guess. You still get to lose some life in some aggressive matchups like against Burn, but I think the fetch lands are way too important when you're playing Mishra's Bubble as well as Murktide. So yeah, I decided to still play a bunch. I'm playing the one Auto Aura, of course, and I think there's no good reason to not play Oboro. The reasoning is that in the late game, you can bounce it to your land and discard it to Shredder. We'll see if it's worth it. The downside is obviously if you get paired against a Blood Moon deck, but I'm guessing people are going to board out the Blood Moons against you. So yeah, sideboard, a lot of cards that you would find in the blue-red sideboards and a few extra like Gus and more Dresdown. I already have 2 in the main, up to 4 just because cards really good. And I think maybe that'll be my plan against something like Hammer Time. Icy Titan, so yeah. Explosives. I think explosives for 0 or 1 is still okay. 0 against Rhino. Maybe against people who are gonna have their own Chalice of the Void, as well as I think the 1 explosives on 1 against Hammer Time could be pretty useful. Some graveyard hate, some chalice, up to 4 subtleties. So yeah, I think Titan is kind of really popular right now. I believe I saw people started playing Hydroid Crisis to help against Murktide especially, I believe, maybe against 4 color as well. Anyways, hopefully with all the subtleties and the Aether Gust, I have a decent game against them, as well as the Dressdowns, even though Dressdown doesn't work against Krasis. And yeah, I think the deck could be good. We'll see. The one thing I'm a little worried about is that Murktide region gets worse after sideboard. I know that when I play blue-red Murktide, I like to go down from 3 Murktides to 2 Murktides in almost every matchup, because almost everyone has a little more graveyard hate, whether it's Hearse or Endurance. So the cards gets worse after sideboard, and I think I might have the same problem here. So might trim down to 2 or 3 Murktides in lots of matchups, might trim some Thoughtscour. So yeah, we'll see. I was gonna actually play Bansal Herder, but the deck that I built a long time ago and that Spike kind of brought back a few weeks ago, but I saw he made a video for Channel Fireball was the Soul Herder deck, so I decided to audible to that deck list that I just scribbled while I was laying on the beach in Greece. It was really nice. I was in a little place kind of middle of nowhere in Greece, and just really simple. Did have internet, but I didn't take my laptop. I was just maybe few minutes here and there on my phone. It was nice change. So yeah, but I guess let me know in the comments if you don't mind when we kind of double up on a deck, you know, especially if the deck is good and popular. You know, obviously we want to bring as much diversity as possible, but I'm guessing that once in a while it's not that bad if there's like a couple leagues of the same deck in the same week while the deck is popular, doing well, etc. I played, I think, two leagues with Soul Herder so far, and it's been good for me. So I might actually play it this Saturday if I play the Modern Challenge this Saturday. I'm just gonna play Ban Soul Herder, maybe trying to see if Spike has updated the list a bit. Bam a lamb. All right, I did end up trimming a land because I added the 4 Thought Scour, so the extra cantrips. We'll see how that works out for me as well. All right, I'm on the draw, and I'm playing against Affinity. I don't have Heracles Recall in my deck. Not a bad hand, though. Not a bad hand at all. Does the 2 lands I need, a couple free spells. We'll see. Could work out. Let's see if we're up against the blue-red or the mono-blue version of Artifact or the blue-white version. Welding Jar, sure. Memnite, yes. It's kind of a problem here. Not a ton of cards that are worth countering for me. Frogmite, okay. That I can probably counter, and I guess I should maybe just use Subtlety. Let's see, I should probably cantrip first, actually. So 1, 2, 3. I need 5 card in the bin. I'm going to have at least 4. So let's do that in response. Okay, I drew a fetch land and I milled 2 instants. That's kind of like the dream. I'm going to force of negation that using... I mean, I'm not sure what Subtlety does for me. I'm going to play Murktide next turn. I'm going to play a 7/7 Murktide, so that's pretty good. But then I'm going to have to race Urza's Saga, getting probably Shadow Spear. Maybe I do need to keep Counterspell. That's going to use the Subtlety, I guess. All right, first game, first turn 2 Murktides. So that's pretty cool. Is it going to be enough, though? Not sure. I need to draw one of my couple dress downs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven artifacts. Let's do all that pre-combat. See what happens. I'm going to discard Counterspell. And I'm going to put Snap in the yards. Really just digging to... Ooh. That might be good enough. So they can make a token, have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 artifacts, equip it with Shadow Spear. Yeah, I don't want to lose my Murktide. Nice, I think that's for the turn 2 Murktide. kind of sad. It might not be enough. We'll see. I do have Murktide plus Counterspell backup. Not sure that's going to matter, though, against a bunch of tokens and Shadow Spear. We'll see. We shall see. They might also just get a drum. Just generate a bunch of mana, especially if they have Bot Monitor. How could I forget about the one of Heracles Recall? See, what am I going to have against them? That's good. Couple Dress Down. Not much. Probably have to bring in Explosives, but they have Welding Jar. I was thinking Explosives just to get rid of Shadow Spear at some point. How do I beat stupid Shadow Spear? Yeah, that's why I didn't keep Murktide back. Their draw is extremely good too. They won the die roll, double saga, a bunch of cheap spells. They even had to draw two out of counter for it, but their hand was pretty nutted. Yeah, I might need to draw a cheap instant here to have a shot. This way I can bin at least two more instants, hopefully. Ooh, Charm. I mean, I can steal the Shadow Spear now, but I don't have mana to equip it. I can steal the token, I guess. That'll be a 1-1 token. Play Murktides. My Murktide at 9-9, that's no good. Problem is, if I steal it, it's still equipped. So it doesn't really help me. I guess they lose one artifact, but it's not that great. Yeah, I guess just steal the token. I do need to worry about Metallic Rebuke. I guess it's too late now. I let them draw. Could have maybe stolen it in their upkeep. I could have kept Shredder back in case they have Counterspell, but if they have Counterspell for my Charm, am I really winning? Not too sure. Wonder what they get now. Maybe Ornithopter if they have that. Ooh, Spell Bomb. It's pretty good. Looks like they're considering moving the Shadow Sphere to Frogmite. Not drum. Forgot they had one floating. This is usually a somewhat close matchup, Murktide against Mono Blue Artifact. I think Murktide is slightly ahead. It gets even better if you have a Heracles Recall. I think playing Artifact Aid in the leagues is pretty good on Magic Online. I feel like the Artifact decks are overrepresented compared to how good I believe they are. I don't think these decks are like top tier and people like them though because they're pretty fun, I guess. Shall I let them attack? Does it matter? Don't want to chum block 1/1. Can I steal anything else? Can almost steal a spell bomb. Guess I'm not gonna chump, so I'll let them attack. Let's see if they have rebuke. Okay. Ooh, subtlety. I guess I just say good, I drew subtlety. If I cast my second Murktide, I'm tapped out. Yeah, I'm just gonna say go. It's on them to do something. And if they want to bounce the Shredder, okay, sure, I'll take a hit. And then I just have lethal with Murktide. Close. Subtlety plus Murktide. Second Murktide growing the second one plus 3, yeah. Okay. I have to remember I have these welding jars. Frogmite. They have one card left. Oh, I mean, it could be bait. They could have a plating and then I lose. But obviously it's really nice if I deny them a Frogmite. I think I'll let them have it. I don't think them having an extra Frogmite is that big of a deal. They probably don't have anything else, but you never know. I mean, I just have lethal, right? The federal land have lethal with counterspell back up. I mean, I guess I could play it super safe. I could play a Shredder and have Counterspell back up. Not sure what I lose to right now. Even just stack with subtlety and say go. All right, I guess I'll just play it very safe. Which I think in this case is right. They do have something. Reality Heist. Wow. I mean, I guess I have to counter that. Good top deck of plating. I lose. But if I let them resolve that, maybe they draw a monitor plus plating. Alright, I guess I should have killed them. I should have gone for it. Figured that last card in hand was probably a brick, so there's nothing that could happen, but I actually had the one card that, or one of the few cards that made it so that my play was really bad, and I just gave them an extra turn. All right. Dress down good, dispute good. Explosive is probably okay. Gutshot kills Memnite, which is reasonable. Doesn't kill anything else. I don't think so. Spell Snare counters plating. I have a lot of cards that are pretty mediocre that I'm going to have to keep in anyways. I think Subtlety is pretty bad too. I think Snap's probably not the greatest. And then there's the whole like Murktide getting worse up their sideboard thing. They might have like more relics and stuff. I think it's tempting to just keep all the Murktides in, but I feel like it's wrong. I feel like I get punished a lot for doing that. All right, let's sideboard like that. Trim a Subtlety, trim a Murktide. Cut the Snappy Boys. I think there's going to be a lot of that, a lot of trimming the graveyard stuff, graveyard reliance stuff. All right. Not bad. Got a force for a relic. A potential turn to Murktide again. That was really lucky to milling, drawing the fetch land, milling two instants. That's pretty great. Drum's fine. Ornithopter's fine. Not that I have a choice. Ginger Brute is fine. All right, now hoping they don't have Saga, or if they do, I draw a dress down. You play some Spreading Seas in my sideboard. There's an argument for main phasing my cantrip in case I draw exactly bubble or maybe a gut shot. As for Sentinel, it's kind of a yikes. I F6 because I figured there was no way I was countering anything really and letting them draw a card of Sentinel. Wander's not nearly as good as Relic for them this game. They might have to preemptively sack it without drawing a card. That card's a pain. Kind of want to counter, but it means I don't get to cantrip if I counter. So I guess I'll let them have it. I'm pretty cautious playing around Snapcaster Mage, I guess. Let's see if they use a lantern right away. They do. All right, I have no cards in hand. And I have a counter spell, so no Urza Saga, please. Speaking of counter spell, next for 1/1, next for counter on Smith. How much damage is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? All right. Hopefully they play a little scared again and I save a point of damage or two. I think they're going to attack with Sentinel. Definitely looks like a game. When you're down to no cards in hand in that spot, it kind of feels like the kind of game where every point of damage can matter. Gonna fetch, gonna use my entire graveyard so I can cast a spell snare or force some negation plus pay for the sentinel. Five five Merc dominates the board for now. Need to dodge like Thought Monitor or another Smith. It's another Smith to get to draw a card. Can eat the Ginger Brute was dressed down next turn. Spell bomb. Got a counter spell bomb. This was counter spell, I guess. What happens if I do it with a trigger on the stack? If it like goes on resolves and then the ability finish resolving and still gains indestructible or unblockable. Oh, I guess I don't know how their rules work. It's not an ability. Weird. All right, I learned something. Maybe I already knew. Either way. This game might be. It's not. I can just steal a Ginger Brute. Okay. We've got a game. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do here. Let's start with consider. Good shot. Oh. Guess I'll start by drawing cards since I'm gonna need to find something like a dress down. I guess I'm gonna have to probably gut shot the ginger brute. Still can't believe I didn't get to kill the ginger brute there. Damn, I needed to draw Dutch Saga for another turn or two. I was in the clear. All right, dress down. Where are you? Rip. Rip, rip, rip. All right. First good news in a while. Right, I need a miracle, a small miracle. Not sure a miracle is even enough anymore. All right. Did see a bunch of graveyard hate, but also kind of wish I drew more Murktides. Huh. A spell sphere now to counter it. They don't have a ton of counterplay to the Murktides. Subtlety just seems not good anyways. All right, let's do that. All right, all land heavy, but pretty reasonable. can maybe set up a quick Murktide. Eh, not really. I'm going to play this deck. I guess that's kind of hand I have to keep. Seems like it should be good. Bubble, Counterspell, Charm, but it's not really what Modern's about. All right, to help me a bit, I'll mulligan. Look at the cards. No, thank you. All right. It's a decent draw. I might scare them. Oh, that was dumb. I mean, I don't have Murktide in hand, so who cares, but... small mistake. It's kind of nice, they mulliganed, so I'm gonna counter a spell, so they're probably gonna feel compelled to sack Lantern when I don't have Murktide. Drum, should I counter the drum or should I counter the creature? I don't think they have multiple zero mana creatures, but they could be sandbagging them. Maybe I should counter the drum. Just try and slow them down a bit. All right, cost is a little too high here, countering that drum. Plating. Plating, I should probably counter. Just playing mono blue. Little mono blue control strat. As long as they don't have Urza Saga, it works. They would have played it last turn if they had it, most likely. Alright, kind of same game as last game. How fast are they gonna draw an Urza Saga? Alright, I think it's worth it. Shred or Dismember, even though it's not the greatest target in the world. Like that, I have an extra land. Ooh, tempting. It's like, if I play it, what's the worst that could happen? They could have Monitor, and then I feel bad. If I don't play it, and they draw an Urza Saga. I wish I had. I think I'm just gonna play it. It does make it more likely that I double spell next turn if I don't play it though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 7. What am I worried about? Can they even cast Monitor? They can't even really cast Monitor right now. Did their last card in hand be a Rebuke? No, that would have countered Shredder. Did have free mana up. All right, I'm gonna say go. Memnite is fine. Probably their draw step. Edge champion. Spicy one. I think I'm gonna counter it, even though I'm not sure I care that much. Just a bunch of flyers racing. I can counter plating. Why would I care about Edge champion? Pro every color. So keeping counter spell is good if they top deck two spells in a row. It's bad if they draw Urza's Saga. They're probably more likely to draw an Urza's Saga than to draw two good spells in a row. Do that for zero or one. Really don't really worry about Urza's Saga. I think I should maybe just dig to dress down. Kind of only card I care about, I feel. Boarded out Snapcaster Mage. I'm racing an Urza Saga now, which is nice. That's obviously fine. This is fine. All right, looks like we win. Little empathy. Never hurts. It's been kind of my experience playing as the Affinity deck, though. Just, I don't know, just not good enough for Modern. Plus, you get the extra pain getting paired against Taki once in a while. Herkers recalls these cards. Yes, no one really plays these cards right now, but I feel like in the league, if you're playing Traverse or Elendemary Skull or a blue deck that sees a lot of their deck with all the cantrips, it might be worth it, honestly, to have the bullets. All right. Always nice to win the first one. Meme deck against tier 2-ish deck. Murktide region wins. Of course, if you like the content and you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, consider doing so. If you want to see more of my videos, more of the videos from the rest of the team, you know the drill. Feel free to like the video if you enjoy it. Leave a comment, all that good stuff. And of course, if you need cards, you can check out channelfireball.com. if you want access to more in-depth strategy articles and deck guides, you can check out CFB Pro. Yeah, all that good stuff. What else? We have wonderful partner, Ultimate Guard. They make some of the best, if not the best, deck boxes in the business. Same goes for the sleeves. Really good stuff. UltimateGuard.com. You can order stuff online if you live in Europe. I think if you live in the US, it goes for Amazon, but check out the website. Let's see. Yurion Misty Rainforest. Guess I'm just going to dumbly play a Shredder here. Could be sick if they go Lightning Bolt somehow. Lightning Bolt my Shredder and I get to gut shut them in response. I mean, I guess at the end of the day, it's kind of a one for one, but it'd be kind of cool. Be not as cool as it just go prismatic ending here. All right. Wow, that's a good draw. Just gonna go ahead and counter that. I can do it again next turn with Snapcaster. Seems fine. Bet a bunch of extra cards. I could maybe just fire up the gut shot and sift through a card, but seems a little loose. Doing a snap, thought scour Murktide. It's really bad if they have Verdict in their deck. I think I should though. It's a decent bit of value. It kind of keeps fueling my Murktide too. Probably gonna discard that Gutshot. Oof. Oof, oof, oof. And Gutshot makes all my creatures bigger. They might have the Ice Fang though. I guess I should just discard a land. Wouldn't be too greedy. Could have gutshot their face, I guess. Then she plus one or two damage. Murktide's bigger. Let's see, puts them down to 13. If I draw a spell, puts them down to 12. My Murktide's one bigger. Put them down to one. I see I'm gonna save my counter spell here. Alright, so they're repping Hearthcast Solitude. Alright, seems worth firing up the Gutshot here. Go down to 11. Spelled snare counters, iteration, run in six, ice fang. Iteration and ice fang pretty rare. Let's see, what if I don't discard a spell? What do I put them down to? 11. Attack for 7, down to 4. Oh man.
Really? Could they have another iteration the way the game played out? They probably would have played it the turn they cycled the Triumph. Unless they drew it. Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty good. Pretty damn good. Oh. What do I have left? One subtlety in my deck. Two subtleties. Guess I should go for it. I could redraw into a consider too. Rip. I didn't think maybe I should have it's they have the fetch time they can gain on my turn and their turn. If I had just kept Auto War, I would have won. Huh, what an idiot. Wow. Getting max punished too. Just flooding out. Wow, that was bad. Why did I feel so far behind when they played Omnath? I kind of just panicked. Now I just have it all. Wow. That sucks. I mean, pretty unlikely to have Ice Fang the way that game last few turns played out. I guess I'll just let them have it. They might play a second spell. I might wanna pump my Shredder. Is that Yurium? Nope. Should fetch first. A little unlucky towards the end, but also mistakes were made. All right. Get me back into this game. For sure. Kind of need double 2-4, right? Yeah. I'll let them have it. Value. Need spell snare. Does that do anything? Kind of. Just have vault. Pretty good one. Am I one? Not even sure how Dresden subtlety works, honestly. Not sure how it works, not sure it matters because I'm at one. Not sure what I can really draw here. Huh. I mean, I guess. Guess Urion doesn't do like everything this game. Fetchland kills me. That was close. Even after I threw the game away. Right, definitely on the graveyard hate and the dispute and the subtleties and maybe Jace. Definitely don't want a gut shot. Let's see, I want all these cards. All these cards. Gus hits Renin 6. Spell Snare hits Ice Fang. I think I like the Spell Snares and maybe not the Spell Pierce. I'm in love dress down. Dismember's probably decent. Force of negation's probably okay. I mean, spell pierce might be decent, but the games are also going to go pretty long. Endurance is going to be a little annoying, but I rebuild a graveyard pretty fast. Dressdown seems fine. Dressdown the play they play, the turn they play on Nef helps a bit. Not super easy to get their Ice Fangs, was it though? Kind of wish I had more Hearse for this matchup. Between the Traverse and the Wren. I'm sorry. Fast Murktide. First, kind of nice, Devrin. If they have an ending, it's not the end of the world. That's fine. I don't think I can gamble here. If I miss my land and F to ferry, I just lose. I mean, I guess that's salty. Actually, that's not true. Probably. Horse could come in handy for Veil of Summer. Or could be good to turn I tap out for Jace. It's kind of a close one. If I didn't have Charm, I would definitely counter, I think. It's just too bad if they have Veil. Just lose the game if they have Veil there. Basic Forests. What the hell? Looks like they have Veil in hand. See why you need more green. Maybe it's just endurance. If I Jace, I get tracked by Veil. Apparently they don't have to do anything here. I think I just have to say go and hope they do something. But I don't think they are going to do something. I don't think they're going to do anything. Please just feel compelled to cast some spells because you have your Veil back up. Not just your own in your hand. Rough. That's like a Jace. I could have Jace plus last turn. Alright, let's not die with 20,000 cards in hand. Let's not just cast Subtlety if they don't do anything again. Game's kind of weird. Doesn't feel like I played great. Yeah. I know it would have been good. I could have maybe gone Jace plus, have a blocker for Solitude, have Force and Dispute up for Urion. Now the game feels kind of tough. I need all my spells. Veil. Trade while I can. I think I get Meddling Mage on Murktide. That'd be pretty sick. It's not even that big, it's a 4/4. I mean, big enough, I guess. I don't think I can really afford to take another hit here. I mean, I could use Force, I guess. You know they have Urion. I'd punish by land Solitude if I use Counterspell here. It's like I'm now. reverse again. It's fine. Your realm's getting countered most likely anyways. I'm gonna draw two first. I just need to snowball. And this way I have force back up and I can pay for dispute. Rough. Alright, that was good. Another Murktai would have been pretty good too. Shredder would be good here. I'm so far behind. I need a lot of charms and Snapcaster. Ice Fangs are so good against my deck, against Murktide. It's like they resolve one Ice Fang and the game becomes exponentially harder. Okay, I mean, some big Murktides. I think I should just trade, honestly. Have Yorion next turn. I feel like I have a great way to get rid of it. Damn. Feels bad, man. Play my land. I'm not sure it's good. I have a Boro. A force pay for a dispute, I guess, is a play. I think my Murktide grows, right? If they blink Endurance, they might not blink it. But it did. I think they messed up. It's too bad it's one off lethal. Oh no, I guess they don't have to target anything. Maybe they don't realize. I think that's how it works. Leaves your graveyard. Let's see it. No, I didn't make the mistake. The tease. Oh, wow. That was a draw. Oh, I should just sag it now. Damn, one damage. So close every time. So close, yet so far. I think that's what it's gonna be. I have to counter that. Ugh. Damn, they had it? They drew it? When did they draw it? Oh, that's probably GG. And I forgot to bounce Autowara. Oh my god. Oh, feels like there's a little room for a win this match. It's probably just over. I'll blame it on the heat. It's still pretty hot here. Heat was nice when I was on a beach in Greece, but it's not as nice here. annoyed. You're probably doing okay with a charm in hand here. Yeah. The unbeatable Ice Fang. Need my gut shots. How am I ever gonna deal that last point of damage? This is so sad. I don't think I am. Guess I'll keep that. Oh, it's Autoaura, right? Well, I guess I'm an idiot. Thought it was... Did I play it thinking it was Aboro and I lost again? Because... Ugh. Sorry. You know me, I don't like when I play like that. It hurts. Pretty sure I played Autoaura at some point thinking it was Aboro. Guess that's why you shouldn't play Aboro. Can't get confused. I might just scoop, honestly. I don't think I can win. Even though... There a chance? There's no way, right? Feels like there's kind of a chance. I'd love to see it. We're gonna shuffle away anyways. I mean, it's pretty good. Maybe they get greedy. They go for the 4 damage. Okay. It's not free flying blockers, but maybe. Maybe not this turn, maybe next turn. Maybe if I draw Autoaura, bounce one of their blockers. Pain. I discard spell since I'm gonna subtlety again and get to loot again. Get Veil, put it on top, Veil, get it back right away. They already played a land this turn though. They just bottomed it. I'd have something else. Okay. Oh. Actually drew the Voro. Yeah, counter spell. What a stupid game. Okay. Alright, I just need another Murktide if I have one left. I'm not sure. I know that Veil in hand. I have 6 cards left. And the loot is not mandatory. Alright, how many Murktides left in my deck? Guess I should play it. I should play it now. Oof. Counterspell plus Veil. Not exactly sure how I beat that. What if I play Subtlety and attack with everyone? They go block here. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. Oh. Okay. I'd have Veil in hand, right? Maybe they'll forget about Veil. But I have Counterspell in hand anyways. Rip. Rip, rip, rip. They actually counter, it's kind of funny. If I play Shredder, I draw 2. Let's see what we can draw. I guess they can just deck me now. They just play their own Veil. And they trigger Shredder a bunch. Am I crazy? Did it just not have Veil? Did they shuffle at some point? Probably just shuffled at some point and then going out of Veil in hand. They literally deck me if they play their Veil there. That's not good. I feel like I came this far. Well, at least I can claim mistakes for makes made on both sides. All right, GG's. Oh. Ah, man. Little frustrating, this one. Little frustrating. I mean, it's on me 100%, but still. I'm going to go get some water. I'll be right back. That's like somewhat competitive. Ice Fang was a nightmare. Ice Fang was an absolute nightmare. All right, solid. Luke Turner. Okay, cool. Hammer time. That matchup's been okay for me. Was Murktide, if we want to compare. Close, but okay. All right, needed that. Let's see, should I fetch first? Damage kind of matters in this matchup. Could matter. It's probably kind of close. I think it's okay to tap out here when they have Sago. Is Counterspell gonna come in handy? It could. But so is pumping my Murktide in. Ooh, actual hammer. Interesting. I'm not exactly sure what really happens here. I guess we're about to find out. Okay, I'm not supposed to let it resolve. I'll let that resolve as well. It feels like kind of blowout city. All risky. Murktide plays Tristan in the main too. It's not like totally unheard of. I've considered first to get the trigger off Shredder, probably. And I guess I might dismember something. Oh, right. I get to probably remember that I played a spell. Of course, I knew that. Calculated. Obviously, calculated. Right, I think I can just play Murktide, right? I mean, we know they have another hammer, but I have counter and dismember. I think worst case, I end up having to chomp with Murktide, but then I can still control the game with my hand. Ah, Paladin. Well, we know they have a hammer. Paladin is not the end of the world. But what can they do if I counter it? Could have Spell Pierce. Spell Pierce is going to be good for them either way. Probably should just counter it. I guess I probably could have said go. Really getting max punished today. Oh, wow. That was amazing. Oh, I'm so dumb. What am I doing? I mean, I guess it's fine. With the main phase hammer, I counter it. At least it's hammer out of the way. I could have fought over Spell Pierce, obviously. It's like kind of fine here. Meme decks and tier 7 gameplay. Not exactly a recipe for success, but I guess I'm still here. I mean, I didn't even do that much right now. don't think so. I think I'm actually better off keeping mana up. Sterilize card in hand. Okay. And just dismember Paladin in response. I can even afford to pay for. I guess I won't. All right, explosives in. Crest downs in. Definitely want to keep Gutshot, I think, and the Dismember. Spell Pierce and Spell Snare seem okay as well. I mean, I don't think Subtlety is very good, but I might need a little help on the draw. If I'll just do that. I have too many 1 minute spells for Chalice to be good here. This hand kind of sucks. This hand's kind of worse. Alright. Get rid of a land and get rid of. Not sure. Not sure if I should try and get lucky. Keep Thought Scour. Ken's gonna be happy if they play turn one Sentinel. Fear of resistance on a 1/1 for one. Not bad. Oh, yeah, sure. It'd be so bad if they didn't have the saga. Sorry, I want to draw that land I bottomed. That outer card I also bottomed. The Dream. Let's see what the bad news is. It is actually very bad news. Okay. Plains Hammer, put me out of my misery. Plains Hammer, I draw explosives for one, is that even good enough? Hello and good luck. And maybe they don't have anything, right? Okay. Draw two, no problem. It's all right. They used up all their luck, clearly. Game three is mine. Classic. I wonder if anyone's ever paid 11 generic mana. All right. All right. You got it. I give up. Chalice on the one on the play. Still don't love it. Bunch of fast Murktides. Why not? Why the hell not? All right, let's trim Snap and Subtlety. This Snap Gutshot's kind of nice. Snap Dismember. Decent. Think I want to draw that. Still want to fetch though. Fast free Murktides. I guess 4/4. All right, I guess I should wait a turn. They have Mana Leak in their deck though. Should say Godrez Dome's nice against Stoneforge. That's what they choose to do. Sentinel is medium fine. Not really fine. X. Yeah. Five five right now, I might be better off playing Shredder first. 19. I want a gut shot. Just to, oh, it's just bad. Another one, probably. Got a little taste in game one. Tough. Tough, tough, tough. Got shot, pretty awful this game. That's what happens when you have to play worse cards. More like Spell Snare, cards like Gutshot. Doesn't always line up very well. Did win a game, but like it was just because it was dressed down blowout. Sentinel is just a little too tough. Ragavan helps a lot. And Sentinel gives you a little counterplay. Some cards you can play in the early turn. Nice, the spot removal is good against them. More explosives too. You just have two explosives, even though you don't have more than one color. You wanted it for exactly one against Hammer almost always, and or pretty often, and zero against Rhino and Chalice decks, maybe. All right. It's been kind of competitive, honestly. Round two kind of through. This was close, question mark. The Murktide part of the deck's been nice. The charms. The Gutshot's been pretty awkward. Not sure about the bunch of Spell Pierce and Spell Snare either. Maybe I should have just recorded a League of Soul Order, but hope people are enjoying the old brew, the little try. A for effort. Matchmaking priority. No big deal. All right, looks like we got a match. No, just a little lag. Menina Ney was a cool 9 extra trophies. I don't know what he plays these days, if it's still Living End or something else. Tutur or Totor. Could be French, Tutur, Arthur. Pretty looking hand. What do you think? Can we find a target for a gutshot? A good target for a gutshot? Gutshot, snap, gutshot. Afternoon coffee wearing off. I'm gonna upload the video and pretty much go straight to bed, I think. Haven't started streaming again yet. It would have been much nicer to see a Ragavan with my hand. Kind of intriguing though, they don't have Companion. They don't have Giganta. It's pretty common for Grixis Shadow. I guess try straight red black, maybe junt. Ooh, excuse me. Dress down. Dress down against junt or shadow. Not sure it does a ton. Is he Voidwalker? Damn, that card's good against me. Lucky. Could dress down and of their turn untap dismember. Dismember go to my graveyard. A ragavan into I think I definitely want to gutshot Ragavan. I guess I should just use my cards, right? Can't afford to just take a bunch of damage here. Well, I can, but probably shouldn't. Another one. Pretty bad draw for them. It's not super useful either. Might not even play the Ragavan to not let me use my mana efficiently. Legit, I think that works, right? Forget, it's been a while. Yeah, okay. That's what I thought. Alright, no fatal push on my Snapcaster Mage, that's nice. Let's see. I'm okay attacking here. I have Dress Down. I'm assuming Dress Down shuts down at least the ability of making a 1-1. And at best, it just turns it back into a land. I'm actually not sure. Fatal Push now. Okay. Oops, too late. Let me see if I can draw a land. My subtlety. Double charm could be worse. I might take a hit next turn. Could almost argue for main phase charm, just hit a land drop. Still have Spellstare mana up. And then just have more mana for the rest of the game. Red, black. Can I make it surely, right? All right, 7/7, good enough. 7/7, good deal. Can't have much. Liliana can salty and then charm. Get the spell snare for terminate. Had the spell snare for terminate. All right, that's good news. Think. Hundred percent just use subtlety there. Drawing dead. And a card. I don't even think I was totally over it right away, too. I'm not sure. I don't remember what initial reactions were. Probably got compared to Tombstalker, like a much better Tombstalker, so it's got to be good. But I think it took a while before that card started seeing a lot of play. It wasn't right away. All right, another game one win. Red black. Red black was Voidwalker, Liliana. Sounds kind of hateful. A spell pierce, not the greatest. Games kind of belong to. Spring in the graveyard hate. Maybe you got force of negation. Just force. Can maybe do more subtleties. Four mana is a lot, though. Feels like a lot. think I'm gonna play a little modern, a little Magic online this weekend, and then start playing some Alchemy on the ladder, start practicing for the Arena qualifier. Even though those Arena qualifiers are just such an absurd uphill battle. So few people qualify, but it's fun. It's fun practicing. It's fun having a reason to play a different format. All right, I'll just keep. I don't need that instance to go with Murktide, but could work out. So I sold your Ragavan turn one. Two for wanting myself. Not sure. Yeah, just rather hope to draw a gutshot in my top two. Alright. That makes it easy. Oh, they might just take bubble since I have a fetch land and I don't know, in some ways, I don't think any discard counterspell might be good. Bubble, bubble, bubble. Don't think I want to draw another bubble. Delaying the draw's downside. Just draw a spell snare for a 2-drop. Draw a thought scour, consider, obviously. Wow. That's so good for me. Dream. Actual dream. Actual dream, except still come cast a Murktide right away. Looks like I lied. Don't have Delirium quite yet. Yeah, I don't think I'm supposed to wait. Liliana, Liliana. I mean, if I subtlety now, then what? Let's not let them have it. I'm just going to dress down in response to Liliana Plus here. Hmm. Let's see. Let's actually just discard Consider and play Subtlety next turn. X got baited. It's not exactly baited when you don't have a choice. Say baited, but what I mean is my opponent got incredibly lucky. Oh my god, I just... Well, that just happened. I mean, I was like in super rough shape anyways. They make me discard. They make me discard my last card. All right, I think I'm just gonna... It might be better in some way, honestly, to let her resolve Copium. Never mind. All right, this game was, I think this game was over, even if I got subtlety. Subtlety this, they just go plus, discard, attack, discard. Just don't kind of backfired. Maybe Gust, kind of overlooked Gust in game two. Dreadzone against Seasoned Power seems really good. Maybe on the play, just more subtleties. Just try to get to 4 mana. And subtly a lot of cards, subtly a lot of spells. Let's try that. Your deck's probably a little too fast for 4 subtlety. For me to sideboard that way, we'll see. On the worst side, bunch of shredders. Repping push. Somewhat unlikely their first line would be Cliff if they don't have something they can cast off it, but with my hand it doesn't matter. Okay. No push. It does have all black leaf cliffs. Urborg. Well, good news is got Shredder to get rid of it. Or you just say go here and draw a couple cards. I'll draw two in response. Well, that makes it easy, I guess. I have all spells. And Murktide is going to be pretty hard to cast. Let's discard Counterspell. Just all in on Shredders. All Shredders all the time. I don't hate it. Man, they still have six cards in hand. At least they don't have too many one mana spells. That's good for me. Their hand seems a little clunky. It's pretty good. It was a hearse. I can just race. That's pretty huge. Could be. Wow. Probably should just keep dead, right? I think it was correct to resolve that one first. Gives me better chance of discarding a spell on one of them next to you. Never draw one mana spells, I'm kind of in trouble. Or even two mana spells. But I guess I'm killing them fast. Spell is good. Ooh. How much damage is that? 5? 6, 7? Eight, nine. I can discard counterspell. I think I can easily discard charm here. And then now I could subtlety Voidwalker, gutshot their face to go down to 11. I'll loot twice. And I have snap gutshot. So that put them down to 10. I need to draw a lot of spells in a row. Feels like maybe I should subtlety here. I'm not sure. That's kind of a two-turn clock. I'm sure what I should pitch, though. Or if I even pitch anything. How badly do I need a counterspell? And I don't really care. I feel like I do care. It's all like kind of straightforward. Just keep counterspell up, protect my Shredder beat downs. As long as I don't have quite the turn 2 clock. 5. Guess maybe it was gut shot and drawing a spell I do. I don't have the fastest clock either. It's right now they don't need to do much, they're winning the race. They're gonna cast a spell. They're gonna counter it. Then hopefully gutshot them for 1 damage. Discard a spell and kill them. That's kind of ideal for me. Close, close, close. All right. I guess I just Lightning Bolts, which They usually don't have a ton of. Do you have lightning bolts? Or unholy heat? Kind of feels like I robbed them there. That's close. Wow. That's all lucky. Probably played that game pretty well, hopefully, once in a while. Alright. Looks like you can play some subpar decks in Modern and still pick up a few wins. I wish a deck like that was actually good. Maybe it's a good thing it's not good. I think like back to basics. It's kind of the sad part. There's not even a great payoff to being mono blue. As opposed to blue red. All right, last round. Hope you're enjoying the very, 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 very chill vibes tonight. Getting back into rhythm. Yurion Companion again. Oof, I'm gonna mulligan. All right, better. And Salty's kind of nice in this matchup, but also already mulliganed. If I start having subtlety spells, it's going to be rough. I think you just hope they don't have the turn to Ren or whatever. Basic Mountain. Kind of love to see it. All right, we dodged. Dodge turn to Ice Fang, turn to Ren. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and counter it. Even though I've got shots. All right, might as well. What did I do? Yes, you just dismember an Omnath there. Two for one yourself. Counterspell, not bad. Farming guide. Excuse me. So they're playing the combo version. Meaning, if I play Shredder, they might have 6 mana Vivian. I think I should play Shredder anyways. And subtlety of Vivian and then spell pierce it. I keep the high impact cards. It's pretty miserable stuff to do that, but oh well. I'm not gonna gutshot just to pump my shredders. I'd rather just save it to discard it to the one shredder that's probably gonna live. So we know, wait, did they somehow bottom solitude? Top. Top, top, top. Unfortunate. But it's not the end of the world, I guess, if they get a solitude. Or is it? Bolt. Upkeep. Huh. I mean, it's kind of tempting. Could snap gut shots. Seems fine. Wait, they already have Uriel in their hand? Maybe it wasn't fine. Both pretty bad. I guess I'll discard the non-blue cards. Is they're gonna cast Solitude, right? I'm gonna get to probably discard Spell Pierce. Yeah, the greatest draws was the floods and the screw a bit. I guess it's bound to happen, but a bit less was for Shredder in your deck. Let's see. Vivian. Alright, I guess that's kind of my out. I need them to play Vivian instead of Yorion. Then I can actually maybe turn the corner. That's funny. Because if they play Uriel now, the game's pretty hard. I guess I could draw Murktide to dominate. I mean, I guess it makes sense for them to play Vivian first. No one plays first on negation, really. won the first one. That's what's important. Gotta hook them in. Wait, did I just f6? Why did they have priority? What's going on? Tell me I didn't just f6. So, could f6. Not gonna lie, I'm basically half asleep. Real professional over here. Alright, I'm only down one card, I guess. Except they have two potential spells and I have a land. What do you have? Another Solitude, I guess. Could just be Ice Fang. Maybe that version plays Ice Fang. Oh, cool. Pick your poison. You're on our second Solitude. I think I might actually need to let it resolve. I guess I could counter, make them play Yorion, hope I draw Murktide. In hindsight, I guess I was supposed to draw to the last turn. Oof. All right, that's just GG. How do I even win? If I counter it, I have no running outs. If I don't counter it, I guess I'm supposed to draw two and hope one of my two top cards is exactly spelled Pierce plus a spell. Alright. Let's end a massacre. I don't want everything in this matchup. I'm not sure how greedy I'm supposed to be. Also not sure if they play Ice Fang or not. Graveyard is probably not very good in this matchup actually, especially on the play I can just counter a Renin 6. Might just be better to have more cheap counters to have the graveyard hate. One drop. Late game secured. Six drops secured. I don't want to have to spend the mana casting that Thought Scour. I was thinking maybe I might want to counter something, in which case I don't really need Thought Scour because I already have. And I didn't have these cards, but you know. That's kind of the reasoning. Not sure I was going to want to spend the mana. Like, my best draws probably involve not having to spend that mana. Up close here. I think it's okay to stay go because I can end up turn draw two. Then don't do anything. That's kind of nice. Let's keep all the spells for now. Verdict? Enough. Or worse. I do have snap counterspell if I subtlety this turn. Probably better just let them have it and use dismember. Makes way more sense. Good draw too. It's pretty greedy though. I can assume Salty's better than Snapcaster. That was nice. Drawing spells. That was huge. Just counter it. Even though I have Dress Down and Subtlety. All right, so all went according to plan. Tough. Not sure about the graveyard hate. Seemed that exciting. Thing is, I don't think the Risen Reversion plays Ice Fang. So the spell snares are just for Ren, maybe all of them are Skull. None of these cards are very exciting. Mage's Gust. And I have no counterplay to turn to Ren, I just lose. As that's not acceptable. I do not know. You could just trim some Murktides. Like trim two Murktides. Force of Negation might be okay on the draw. Or Thought Scour. May keep in all the Snapcasts for mages too. Should've just got all the Murktides. I don't hate it, honestly. Next level. Got all the Murktides, all the Thought Scours. Right, let's try that. Not sure why I would do that. They don't even have Ice Fang, do they? Don't know. I think it's okay. I'm kind of turning into like more of a control deck, I guess. Seems fine. That's gonna be awesomeness again. Ooh, scroll. Oh, this game could be over real quick. Death turn to Teferi. Risen Reef. Well, that's not much better. For that gut shot, yes, sure did. Not sure I should dismember it right away. Because if I dismember, they go omnap, I have to dress down, and then what? Whereas if we do the other way around, I dress down in response to omnap. I kill Omnath and then have Risen Reef, but I can counter more elementals. Tricky. Guess I'm going to play straightforward. Fair. Not fair at all. Game's totally over. Jeez. Well. I tried. Four colors pretty tough. Let's see, do they have a fetch land? They do. Teferi, what else do we know about? Not a Risen Reef. All right, GG's. And I wish I'd played against a little less four color this league. Got half my buy-in back. Would I recommend playing this deck? Well, if you're trying to win, probably not. If you love to cast all blue cards, I'm not sure. Probably not. Anyways, if you made it this far without falling asleep, congrats. I was, I had fun. I had fun playing this league. It was fun. It's fun to be feel like you're constantly on like a uphill battle, but yeah, as I said, it'd be nice if there's a little more of a payoff to play monocolor. Hopefully they print some cards somehow that rewards you for being monocolor. Maybe a good special land. Something like Hall of the Storm Giant or Castle Vantress, but better. Or what else could they do? I guess more cards like, more kind of overpowered cards like Charm. Not sure if that's good game design or not, but yeah. Because you don't even really get to play Field of Ruin in this deck because you really want to play Charm and just have double blue and stuff. So even Field of Ruin doesn't work, doesn't really reward you for playing mono blue. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you all have a great week, and I will see you next time. Take care, everyone.